Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads, and today we're going to be talking about the Natural Reader app. It's a text-to-speech engine, so let's go ahead and take a look.
So today I wanted to talk about Natural Reader 16. This is a text-to-speech program. We've covered a couple, a different version. We've covered a Chrome extension version of this. This is actually the personal version. It's a program version, so you can load it to your computer. And then really from within the program itself, you can upload PDF documents, text documents, Word docs, EPUB, all sorts of different types of information into it. And it's going to read it to you. What I do love about this program is you can just simply drag in a file. And so out here on my desktop, I've got this case study file, and I'm just going to drag it. It's a PDF version. I'm not going to take all of them. I'm going to grab one of them. I'm just going to drag it into the program. And then it's going to go ahead and start bringing that information up. And once it's ready, I can go ahead and hit the play button. And it's going to start reading to me.
Case study, Lisa. Background. The information in this plan was compiled through home visits, observations, conversations with Lisa, her family, her support staff, and collateral information from Lisa's file.
And I'm going to hit pause there. Notice that when it does read, it's actually going to open up a window at the bottom of the screen that brings things up in large print. It makes it easier for you to see and will highlight as you go so that you can read through it. It's got a couple of other options here. It's got some different voice dropdowns that you can choose a different voice. You've got some natural sounding ones or the built-in Microsoft voices. Currently, we're using Microsoft David. You also have a speed control, so if you like to hear things a little bit faster or a little bit slower, depending on your comprehension level, you can kind of increase or decrease that to a level that suits you. You've also got some controls over here on the side, so I'm going to go close out my speed. I'm going to come over here and drag over a couple of these. There's this auto track text. That's the highlighting part. It's kind of tracking it as you go. You can search for keywords within that document. You can bookmark information. You can zoom in on information. Maybe there's a picture in your document. You want to zoom in on it a little bit. You can also adjust the reading area. So just being able to select certain parts of the text to be able to read. All sorts of great ways and tools to be able to use within this program. And again, it's as simple as just simply dragging a file into it. Other things, you've got this more button over here. You can kind of look up different documents that you've loaded in the past. Maybe you did something yesterday and you want to come back to it today. You can bring that up. There's a pronunciation editor. So maybe you have a unique name and the computer doesn't pronunciate that well. You can actually change that pronunciation so that when it comes across that word down the road or the next time it comes across that word, it reads it correctly for you. And it's got all sorts of really helpful tools available to you under that More button as well.
Well, that's your tech tip for today. I want to say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads in Indiana.